Hey guys, in today's video we're going to go into how to build a long-term sustainable dropshipping brand store business in 2019. Okay, let's go. Hey guys, so here are the results you can see from a dropshipping brand store of a client store in this case that I've been helping to scale their business, okay? They've been doing a fantastic job and I helped them to bring it to that next level, okay? And you can see here that they've got over $100 average order value just from doing this yesterday, okay? That's how awesome this is, okay? And so I wanted to discuss that with you because people seem to forget that everyone wants a quick get rich quick scheme, okay? But that's not really what the aim of this game is. You need to put in the hard yards, and the hard yards takes a lot longer, all right? So it's really important. So before we do get into this though, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit that notification bell, and follow me on Instagram at Ricky Hayes IG. I will also be giving away a free winning product this video, some part along the video, so make sure to stay tuned. Get all the value, write it down, enjoy. All right, guys, let's get straight into it. Okay, guys, I just wanted to, before we get into this, show you exactly what the benefits of building a brand store, sustainable brand store is, as opposed to just trying to just do, you know, items and bad quality, get bad ad score and everything like that, okay? You can see here that this is from yesterday. So we can see here that this is the 25th of the 1st, 2019. We can see all of that there, okay? And we can see here that $206 spent, okay? So I had set up $206 in ads and a number of that was testing. So about $60 of that, in fact, truthfully speaking, was wasted budget, but that's part of it, you know, testing. And you can see here that $2,658 in revenue. Had two large orders that day, but you know, you can see here 24 orders, shipping cost $180. This is a US-based store, of course. You can see here that the average order value is $110. Okay, $110. Now, that's not going to happen every day, but you can see how if you aim for quality, customer service, and longevity, this is the type of results that you're going to get, okay? You can see here that the individual has gotten literally $1,528 in a single day for 24 orders. Okay, and so obviously there's a bit of work involved there, but this is what I try and teach. Okay, this is how I'm different to other people, is I don't talk about the here and now. We all need the sales here and now, but remember that this is long term. Don't forget that the point of what I try and teach you is all about long term. Imagine if you made $1,528 in a single day, okay? I define that personally, like based on my budget of living lifestyle, like that's literally a month's wage in a day. Easy. So, you know, let's aim for something like that. You can see here the profit margins are exceptional, okay? You know, you can see the shipping charge, you know, you can see the gross margin, 67%. Okay, guys, you're not going to see that very often, okay? And you can see here that's actually less than yesterday. So you can actually see that if you really hone in on building a brand store and really take your time, as painful as it is, this is the type of results you can get, okay? And it means that you got less work, larger average order value, less issues, okay? A number of these people, they came back and bought a second time, right? When people come back and buy a second time, they're less likely to hinder you as well in terms of asking where the order is and stuff, because they've already gone through that experience. They now fully trust you. They've had a really good experience and they come back and buy again. And so all of a sudden now, you are you're really getting to that next level. Okay, guys, so let's get into how you can actually achieve this. All right, guys, and as promised, here is the winning product, which is a baby pacifier. Okay, guys, you can see here it's trending. Just in a few months ago, we can see it hit 1.7 million views on this. We can see as well, it's got easy copy. We've got plenty of people that are from United States and Western countries that are engaging in this, that have been buying it. You can go to the URL. And if we have a look here on AliExpress, we can see here that the product has had thousands of orders in the tens of thousands across multiple products. So that's definitely a winning product. If you are after a winning product, I would definitely suggest marketing that. Market it to women, mothers, baby magazines, mothers magazines, anything relating to mothers, famous mothers, for instance. Okay, guys, and start with those. And obviously any brand baby websites would work perfect with this and you're good to go. So for starters, we need to talk about average order value. Okay, so AOV is the acronym for it if you don't know what that is. Okay, and so the point of what average order value is to explain it for beginners is, you know, rather than getting a 100 customers in that spend $10 a day each, and you know, you get $1,000. If you increase that by $5 on average per individual, all of a sudden that's $1,500. Okay, so that's why average order value is so important, because it allows you to push higher so you can outcompete your competitors. Okay, that's what the whole point really of average order value is. If any of you have read Russell Brunson's books, any of these books which I have here, you've seen them in the video, I love those books, is he says the whole method of whoever can spend the most wins. If you have competitors that you need to spend $100 on average, let's say, to acquire a customer, imagine the difference it could make if you could profitably spend $150. Because all of a sudden you give things longer time to optimize. You don't have to worry as much. You can still be profitable, okay? So that's why we do this. So to do this, you need to install apps to increase your average order value, like booster apps, bulk discounts, okay? That app is $20 a month for quantity discounts. So encourage them to buy two or more, okay? And that'll show in the cart page as well, to try and really encourage them. And the more they add, it's gonna say add another and get, you know, add two, get 10% off. Add three, get 15% off. And that's each, okay? And the reason that I recommend that one is it has a detailed view of that. They don't just see like they get 15% off. They get 15% off each. I mean, you can hard code that, but that's important, because if people see that they can get 15% off each, that means like, wow, that's a big saving. So all of a sudden, an order that could be $20, they order three, normally it'd be $60, and they get in total a 15% off each. I don't know, whatever that would be. They save 15, 16 bucks, but you've made an order go from average $20 to $42. And you've taken a small cut for that, but you've gotten a lot more money in the back pocket. Okay, that's really important. That's number one. Two, I use an app called Frequently Bought Together. That's $7 a month. Absolutely one of my favorite apps. What it does is it bundles items, okay? And it uses algorithm. It looks like Amazon. Amazon's Frequently Bought Together. Go to their webpage and you'll see it. Install the app. It's got a 30-day trial. And it's absolutely awesome. I literally set it so that it bundles two items together, and I give at least a 10% discount if they add it and obviously subsequently go and purchase. And it just makes a dynamic coupon code in your checkout so that they just can go ahead and purchase. Keep in mind that some of these apps do obviously have issues with third-party checkouts. Personalizer is especially useful for in-cart upsells. So this is why I always recommend sending people to the cart page and send it to a page, not a drawer. Drawers do still have the in-cart upsell, but I find pages work better. And basically then you can, again, try and increase the average order value through booster apps, but also using Personalizer. They're going to see a dynamic item that's similar to that, where it's going to try and upsell them. So all of a sudden you're doing bulk order discounts, you're also doing bundles, and then you're doing bundles on the cart page as well. And you're just really trying to reaffirm that and really trying to push them to increase in the average order value. Because if you can increase it again, even a dollar makes a huge difference. People seem to forget how much it makes. Because especially this becomes important as you scale. Every dollar becomes a dollar saved, means a dollar you can spend on your marketing and outcompete the competition. Okay, because the things are getting more competitive. Okay, so average order value is really important. Do not forget that. Next step is how to get more customers, okay? So one of the things people forget way too much is they're leaving way too much money on the table from the get-go. And I've been there, I've done that, you know, we make many mistakes. But I wanted to give some tips, okay? So install Wheelio for exit intent. So when people are about to leave your website, it shows a pop-up, okay? And you incentivize them to opt in, and then you give them a discount so they actually subsequently go ahead and purchase. Okay, Wheelio costs $15 a month, completely inexpensive. It'll pay for itself in probably like a day or two, depending on how much marketing you do. The app is awesome. SMS Bump, again, another app that I absolutely love that will help get a lot of customers back. Get a lot of customers back that didn't already purchase. So it's, you know, people that go all the way to checkout and they leave at the last minute, you get their number, and you can remark to them. That works extremely well, extremely useful app. Klaviyo for abandoned cart emails. Again, I have a video on that, and I also have one on SMS Bump. Go and watch them, they're in my channel, you know, down below. Klaviyo, there's a sequence, and you use the sequence, and that'll help you get sales really easy. Klaviyo is free to start with, so don't worry about that. DPA ads, I always set up DPA ads as the first thing I do until I scale a product really high, and then I use custom audience ads. But DPA ads, I'm $5 a day and people will come back and buy. Okay, I've got a new store that's running at the moment, and I'd be even less profitable than I am right now if I didn't have DPA ads. And you know, like, it spent, I think, $13 for 3 sales, the average order value of about $30. Okay, so you know, you can see, and that's on autopilot, right, guys? It's autopilot, really important. You know, you want to build trust with your customers. Now, I forgot to include this as well. If you want a trust badge, preferably a trust badge underneath your cart button, but you want to build trust with your customers using a review app like Looks. I used to use Ali Reviews, but I use Looks now, and import some reviews from AliExpress. Try and get ones with images. There's plenty of choice out there, okay? And that helps build trust because they see the reviews and like, yep, okay, I'll go ahead and buy it myself. And also, you want to set up abandoned cart remarketing. Okay, guys, so that is in the form usually of Recart. Admittedly, there have been changes there, so it is a bit harder, but you can still use Recart, okay, guys? And you can see between all of these, we've got so many types of building trust, but also getting people to come back and buy. And that just means the difference between you and out being in the competition is substantially higher because, you know, you're sending out an SMS, you're sending out emails, you're sending out Facebook remarketing, you're doing Messenger remarketing. You can even go to the degree, once you really get established, you can do like Google brand campaigns, okay? You know, you can do all these forms of remarketing because remarketing is where you get a lot of the real cash, okay, guys? So that's where a lot of people are missing out, and that's where a lot of people end up just blowing a lot of money without any results at all. But by doing some of these things, you're gonna get a lot more. It'll help boost your conversion rate while also, you know, just your overall customer base. And the biggest one that I want to talk about that I'm the most passionate about is increase your LTV, lifetime value per customer. Okay, so you know, most stores, it's no lie to say that most have about probably 3-4% return rate. And that's fine, that's not a bad thing, but there are ways that we can do it now to increase your LTV. And you need to increase your LTV because it's just really important to do. People forget, like people get so caught up in just constantly acquiring new customers that we forget that past customers are far more likely to buy. They've already gone to that degree. It's far cheaper to get a new, a repeat customer than it is a new customer. But you always need new customers so that you get more repeat customers, okay? So they work in conjunction. Don't get those mixed up. But always look at LTV as your priority, but always look at getting new customers so you can increase your LTV. Okay, that's important. I wanted to describe that. So do post-purchase upsells like using Reconvert, OCU, one-click upsell, Carthook. I recommend Carthook. There's a link down below. That is an affiliate link as well. Send messenger notification on purchase and shipping offers, okay, and shipping and offer discount. So like one of the things I see no one really doing properly is I upsell every opportunity that I really can that makes the most sense. So when someone purchases, they get an email, right? They're gonna get an email. They're gonna get a purchase confirmation email. So why not in that purchase confirmation email, tell them about, you know, try and give them a discount, but also upsell, give them a discount, but also tell them of the shipping times. Okay, so in Shopify, there's the Shopify notifications and you got your purchase confirmation and shipping confirmation, sorry, order confirmation. And basically, you know, you can actually with Klaviyo, there's templates that you can use and you can modify them so you can change the text to say what the expected shipping times are because that's 100% everyone's gonna get that email. Okay, and those have really high open rates. You can't see it, unfortunately, in Shopify, but they will have really high open rates because people want to see it's basically their receipt. So they see on their receipt their shipping times, so you give them a discount, okay? Give them a discount. And just the way you gauge if it's working is you make it a unique discount in Shopify and just check your discounts. There you go. Okay, that's an upsell, you know, increase post-purchase upsell. Using Reconvert to post-purchase upsell to get them to come back and buy again. OCU to get them to buy again while sending them through a funnel. Carthook does the same, and I prefer Carthook again. But you can send Messenger as well, do the same with Messenger, and you can do the same with text. Is, you know, you send them a Messenger saying, you know, here's your purchase confirmation, here's a discount, here's a 20% discount, come ahead and buy again. And that'll work in its autopilot. And then you do the same for your shipping confirmation. We've just shipped your order while it's waiting to arrive, while it's on its way diligently to your front doorstep. to your doorstep, here's another discount, okay? Another 20% discount. You know, do the same with the email flows, post-purchase flow, okay? Just send them a day after another email just saying, hey, you want to come by again? And that actually scared me. My camera turned off. Oh my gosh. Anyway, do the same for text flows, okay? So text flows, I actually admittedly don't find work as well for some reason. But, you know, once you're getting consistent sales, there's no reason to at least try it. Different audiences work different ways. You know, keep customers updated on where the order is at, okay? If you're using Aftership, turn on the emails, okay? And you can even turn on the text. You are going to get some complaints, admittedly, but, you know, you're going to get complaints regardless. Yeah, you know, turn those on because people like being kept updated. It's going to reduce your customer service and also increase your customer satisfaction. The more customer satisfaction you have, the more chance you have of a repeat customer. And then you can upsell them in the actual emails and that, you know, like give them the shipping times and at the end, give them a discount, you know, and then people will come ahead and buy. You know, it won't work a huge amount. But what we're talking about is simple little things that make or break a business, okay? Reply to emails, okay? I can't emphasize on this enough. Actually reply to your damn emails. They're annoying and disheartening. And you know, don't waste their time. I use G Suite, and you can integrate using Zendesk, okay? And you can make templates in Zendesk to basically help respond to them, and then you sort of customize them. And obviously, you're gonna have a VA. You know, if you're scaling, use a VA. I forgot to increase that, you know, because then they can respond faster, which helps increase your customer satisfaction and LTV again. You know, reply to their live chat messages on your Facebook page, which goes, I suggest ManyChat for that. It's absolutely fantastic tool. So I definitely recommend using ManyChat for that. And I have a video on that as well. Go and watch that. You know, get the product and improve the quality through private suppliers. Okay, so get a private supplier. There's plenty in my Facebook group. There's plenty in other Facebook groups. Just reach out and try and find some private suppliers. See if they can source your product. See if you can get it modified, as simple as that. And, you know, bulk order discount. I did forget to include this as well. But, you know, you want to brand your products with a business card and quality packaging. So there is actually psychology that if you can get really good packaging, I know some people that are going to the utmost degree with the most insane packaging, and it's going to work so well. And you know, it's because they're really trying to hammer home on a brand, and they're working so hard on that. Okay. Also, as well, you know, if you are scaling, use something like ShipBob to import to the US, because that's probably where most of us are getting sales from for the US, and use ShipBob to send out, because they got like a 1 day processing time with usually a 1 to 3 day business delivery time using USPS, FedEx, and UPS, so as well as DHL, sorry. So really good, and that helps the LTV, because, you know, if someone gets it within 4 days, they're going to be far happier than if they have to wait 3 weeks, okay? So, but don't do that until you scale. Introduce new products and send out 2 email campaigns, 2 text campaigns, and 2 messenger campaigns. I recommend this to every one of my students, in fact, and this is obviously... The Sneeze King is back. Anyway, and this will help basically increase your organic sales, which again is, you know, what our goal is. You know, I don't care what anyone says. I would much rather acquire 10 customers sending out an email campaign than 50 customers using Facebook ads and worry about the margins there, where I know I've got 100% margin and all I did was send out a campaign with a discount, okay? And so, you know, I may have... whatever that profit margin will be, but, you know, all of a sudden, you know, you're counting for rainy days. I see it a lot, and I've had it a lot too, you know, rainy days where they happen, and sending out a campaign text or whatever, or messenger, you know, helps with those rainy days. And the reason that I say 2 campaigns, 2 texts, and 2 messenger is you're going to build those lists. You're going to build all 3 of those lists. You should use them all, but you shouldn't spam them. So you can see how this strategy allows you to essentially send out a campaign every day for some, nearly every day for some organic sales, while not smashing that list. And yes, there's going to be overlap, but that's inevitable. But you're going to use that, and so, you know, people unsubscribe. It's not going to smash your list all the way back down to nothing. It's not going to piss people off getting the same marketing channels, because it's going to work different ways. So, because some people won't look at their text, some people will only look at email, vice versa, all of that, okay? So that's really important to keep in mind, and that's the approach that I've generally done. So you build these 3 lists through paid campaigns while you're also then using them for organic campaigns, and you just keep building on it, and you're not smashing your audience, okay? And that's going to help with the LTV, getting a lot more repeat customers. Increase your Facebook and Instagram page, obviously, as well. You should always be doing this. I see too many times a common mistake for one is people are doing ads and they're doing it on Instagram. Now, most people I'm seeing now are mainly getting most of their sales again from Facebook, but make sure you have your Facebook as your Instagram as a business page and integrate in your business manager, and you have that set as the page in your ads, okay? Because you are going to build followers. And you want to build those followers because you might become an influencer. Someone could, or you know, most of the time we're just going to send our shop catalog there, and you're going to promote some products and get some organic sales, guys. Okay, really important that you do that. Facebook page as well. You know, spend the time and do the about us. Do optimize your Facebook page a bit, especially as you start getting more sales. Optimize your Facebook page, your cover image, your profile image, Instagram page, all of those channels, because it builds trust, it builds lifetime value for your customers, okay? Never forget that that's what you really want to do, and I've always said that, and it's really important. I prefer to look at long-term, okay? Short-term profits might be lower, maybe you're not making any profits at all, you may be losing money, but remember that if you want to make this a lifelong income, this is what you need to do, okay? And so I'm trying to teach you the mindset as well as the methodology. So run monthly competitions as well. So on Instagram and Facebook and any other organic method that you have, if you have a YouTube, there's no reason to not do it. Just put it at the end of your video or at the start of your video, something like that. Okay, guys, really important that you do that because that's going to help keep your audience engaged. It's going to help build up your lists because there'll be a lot of people that aren't in your lists, and get them in your lists and build that up and build more organic sales from that slowly but surely. Okay, really important that you do that. All right, guys, so I hope that makes sense. So that concludes today's video, guys. I hope you have really enjoyed it. I enjoyed giving you that value. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit that notification bell, okay? And follow me on Instagram at RickyHayesIG. I also lastly wanted to add as well that my mentoring program and coaching program links are down below, plus a heap of other value as well. So if you do want to join my mentoring program, we do need to go through a discovery call, but the link is down below with further instructions on that. Lastly, I wanted to give a shout out to my friend Ivy Zhu. He has a YouTube channel himself as well as a Facebook group, etc., etc. And I wanted to give a shout out to him for his YouTube channel because he has a unique perspective on how he runs his YouTube channel, in that he tries to do an ongoing 100% transparent case study from where he was to sort of where he is, and he's hitting really big numbers. We've been speaking for a while, and I wanted to give you guys a different perspective, okay? So I give a lot of value myself. I'm very proud of that, but I also acknowledge that I haven't done many case studies and that myself, and I know that a lot of people ask for that. And so when we've been talking, I thought, well, this is a good opportunity to help a fellow YouTuber out who is trying to give real value to people. And I can tell you, he does give a lot of real value. We're both trying to give the community as much real value as possible, okay? You know, not just trying to skimp you all, but give you actual real valuable, tangible information that you can use to put into your business today to get real results, because that's what we're here for, okay, guys? So I hope you have enjoyed today's video. I will catch you in the next video. Have a lovely day. Take care and goodbye.